In our previous lesson, we saw pandas series selection or indexing, which was basically selecting individual elements out of a series. It could be one element, it could be a range of multiple elements with slicing, but basically it was, I wanna pick these or these items and how can I get a handle on them? When you know the actual position in the index, you can just do the regular selection that we know, right? Which actually turns out that internally it's a dot lock operation, we said, but with using pandas series we can avoid it. We can just do the regular selection as we said in this line 5. We will actually need this for data frames later, just heads up, but again, when using series it's pretty much the same thing to do lock or without lock. We also saw that series are a sequential ordered structure, so we could select elements out of their sequential position. So for example, the first, the last, the third element, and this is useful when we don't know the given position of the index, or sorry, the actual index that we want to select. Similarly, we also saw that there was a multi-selection, right? That we call it kind of Boolean selection. We can pass a Boolean array, or a list in this case, in which we pass either false or true values depending which items we want to select. So in this case, I'm just going to run this line, and this line right here is pretty much the same as the one before, but it's a little bit more explicative. We are here showing what countries we want to select. So we want to select France, Germany, and Italy, because we're passing true values on those positions. False for Canada, Japan, the UK, and the US, so those will not be returned. As I told you in our previous lesson, it's kind of annoying, of course, to type this array by hand, by literally just typing the true and false values. So why does it exist in the first place? Who is creating these arrays? Who's typing? Suppose you have a series that has a million elements. Who could possibly type a million times true or false to actually specify what elements they want to select? The reality is that we never type manually these Boolean arrays. These Boolean arrays can be created with expressions on our series, and this is going to be a very important topic. We will actually do a couple of exercises in this lesson, and we're going to revisit these 4 data frames later. This is going to be a very important topic. So let me show you what is one of those conditions or one of those expressions that will generate these Boolean arrays. So you already saw that some mathematical operations in series, right, could give you different results. So for example, G7 pop has the population of the countries in millions of inhabitants. I could, for example, multiply everything by 1,000, right? And we are pretty much applying this whole vectorized operation to the whole series. Now, there is something important here, which is this is a mathematical operation. There are different types of operations in programming. This is a mathematical one. There's also a Boolean operation. What happens if this operator right here is a Boolean? For example, I say G7 pop greater than 70, right? So let me run it here before we actually store it in a variable. Let me show you what this thing returns. What you have right here, and I can get rid of these ones so we don't get confused, is an expression, a Boolean expression applied to a pandas series. And what we see is that it returns a Boolean series. For each one of the indices that we have in the original one, is basically answering this expression is false for Canada, false for France because they have less than 70 million inhabitants. It's true for Germany, because Germany actually has 80 million inhabitants. It's false for Italy, it's true for Japan, it's false for the UK, 64 is less than 70, and it's true for the United States. So this condition, again, what it's doing, or this expression, sorry, what it's doing, it's evaluating this expression individually for each one of these elements and returning true or false for each one of them. Why is this so important? Because if we combine these Boolean expressions with the Boolean selection that we saw before, what we will end up having is just Q conditional selection. We're gonna do selection, we're gonna select items that meet a given condition. So let's see the same condition again. What I can do now is do that selection on my series. And if I put everything together, this expression right here is gonna put everything together, line 15. This is usually the way we do it. We don't store it in an intermediate variable. So this expression is what we're looking for. It's a way of filtering your series. I wanna, basically what we say is, I need all the elements from this series in which this condition applies, or basically that this condition happens, and it's, the condition is that all the countries that have more than 70 million inhabitants. As you are seeing, there is a little bit of repetition here. I have to say, I wanna select from this series under this condition. So it's not that you can just say, whatever is G7 pop greater than 70. You have to repeat it. But again, this is a very powerful expression. And actually, we will be able to combine it it's gonna be very, very powerful down the road. This expression can be whatever you want. So for example, it doesn't have to be a hard-coded value. I can use a computed value. For example, the mean, what's the average number of inhabitants for each country? And I can use that as the result of my expressions. Of course, that these results are just series. So we can, once we have one of those series generated, we can store them in a given variable, or we can do any other operation that we want. Now, mathematical operations, they are all chainable, right? I'm going back again to the mathematical operations. You could do the series plus that other series, plus that other series, times that other series, etc. Boolean operations are also chainable, but to chain Boolean operations or expressions, you need a given number of operators, and, or, not, etc. So let's look at them. We can actually chain two expressions that are, for example, I wanna select all the countries from G7 pop in which these two conditions have to, or it, sorry, actually either of one of these conditions is met. So it's either greater than 70 million or less than 40 million inhabitants. So let's run these examples separately here. We're gonna do again G7 pop. And now we're gonna do, first, let me show you what G7 pop greater than 70 has. We know it already. It's this one and this one and this one, right? So true, true, and true. But we're also adding an OR operation. We're basically saying, I want to select all those countries that have more than 70 million inhabitants or less than 40, okay? And which are those countries that have less than 40 million inhabitants? Only Canada that has 35 million. So what if we put everything together, what we have is the operation that it's either this condition or this condition. In an OR operator, all the true values are pretty much added. It's like a union operation in sets, if you are familiar with sets. But basically, the result is gonna be this one. We have the United States because it has more than 70 million. We have Japan because it has more than 70 million. We have Germany because it has more than 70 million inhabitants. And we have Canada because it has less than 40 million inhabitants. So if I run this operation, we are actually gonna select all those countries given this condition. The same thing applies for and. In this case, we can say, we need all those countries that have more than 70 million. Let me actually copy these things so we can sit next to this one. All those countries that have more than 70 million inhabitants and less than 200 million inhabitants. So now we are shrinking our selection. It has to be more than 80. Germany has more than 80. Japan has more than 80. But it has to be less than 200. So the United States will not qualify for this because it has more than 200. So the AND operation is kind of an intersection, right? We have to, the condition has to be met in both extremes of the operation, if you want, in order to be completely true. If I run this operation, you will see exactly that. We have Germany that has more than 80 and less than 200. The same for Italy. The United States is not there because it does have more than 80, but it has more than 200 too. So this is not met. These two operators we've seen are different from what you're used to in regular Python. In regular Python, we literally type and or. When using pandas, you must use these operators, the ampersand and the pipe, which are again representing the or, the pipe is representing or, and the ampersand is representing the and operation. You have to use these, you can't use and or. There is a good reason behind that, but just for now, take my word on it, you need to use these. Something else you need to do is you must, let me copy this line to show you something, you must surround each individual expression with parentheses, because if you don't do that, you're gonna have an error. Let me show you what we have. Because the precedence of operators will change. Basically, in this operator has more precedence than this operator. So we must here surround the individual expressions with parentheses, and we end up again with a chain of all these operators. So again, you could keep chaining these as many selections as you need. I need more than 70. You can, of course, once we see a data frame, you have multiple columns, we're gonna be able to chain expressions of multiple columns. That's gonna be very, very helpful. Finally, another important operator is the not operator. So the three Boolean operators that we know are and, or, the ones we've seen, and also the not operator. So for example, I can say, I need to select all the countries that have, for example, less than 70 million inhabitants, or actually say, I want to select all those that don't have more than 80 million. It's either I need to select, for example, blue and red out of three colors. They have blue, red, and green. I can say I need to select blue and red, or I could actually say I want to select not green, so everything but green. This is the same thing. So I'm saying I want to select all the countries that don't have more than 80 million inhabitants. So if we pull again the series, that don't have more than 80 million inhabitants, these tilde, this wiggly thing, this tilde, is actually the not operator, and it's negating this whole expression. I'm gonna show you something interesting in a second. So again, this is negating this whole expression. What we're doing right here is, these are the countries. We say they don't have to have more than 80 million inhabitants. So this one has more than 80 million inhabitants. That is not correct. I don't wanna select that. Is not more than 80. So basically is everything below or equals to 80 million inhabitants. Why is this interesting? Because the not operator, and it's something also, it's also something that happens in Python. You know, in Python you have, for example, x equals true. If you do not x, what you're doing is you're flipping the value, right? So if I have false and I do not false, what I actually get is true, right? So not false is gonna be true, and not true is gonna be false. We're flipping the values. That's something that happens just with Boolean logic in general. If you have this expression, right? And I'm gonna run it, I'm gonna copy below, but I'm gonna negate it first. So I'm gonna copy this one right here. I'm gonna negate the whole thing. I'm gonna put a not on top of it. What you're gonna see is that everything that was false now becomes true, and everything that was true becomes false. So again, it's what countries do have more than 80 million inhabitants? Well, here, Germany, Japan, and United States. So then you do not, basically say, well, I don't want those ones. Which countries have more than 80 million inhabitants? These three will actually flip everything. I don't want those ones, I want the other ones. And again, these operations, they can all be just, you know, you can use computed values like the mean, like the standard deviation. There is a more complicated example for you to see what we mean here. Basically, we're selecting all those countries that have a value that it's two standard deviations above or below the mean. So again, it's just a more complicated example on purpose, so you can see how these operations can grow. There are a couple more things to see. The first one is this isin operator might be useful, right? So in this case, you could say, I want to select those countries that have this proportion. This is also a Boolean operation. If we inspect it individually, is the isin method. Right here, it's something else we can do. And finally, these Boolean operations can be also used for modifying series. So we could say all those countries that have more than whatever 300 something million inhabitants, let's just simplify them to 300, for example, just making it up. But basically you can run an update process when you're doing your selection. So everything that meets this criteria will now be modified with this new value. If you are using the plus equals operator, right, you can just, you can avoid doing doing any sort of like duplication of expressions. And you can just do, well, let's actually modify this in place. We can say all the countries that have more than 100 million inhabitants, we're gonna just add 5 to them. So as I told you at the beginning, this is a very important topic. So keep practicing on it. We are also gonna use these filtering and selections on data frames, but as you can imagine, we will be using these very often. Filtering things, selecting things is very important. So again, get a handle on the exercises, try to complete them, and we will keep working with these from now on. You will see it appearing soon, pretty much all the time. So please do the exercises so you can be proficient with this selection. Our objective is, if we tell you, you need to filter all the products that have more than 50 sales in the first 5 days of June, whatever, you should be able to write these expressions, you know, out of the top of your head.